Remember one day, though, he called me. It was Mangal Arati. And it was nice. And I was walking down the path on my way to the temple room, and I was singing Jasomati Nandana, kind of, you know, it was happy-go-lucky mood, right? Which was, when you're with Prabhupada, that's the mood, you know, happy. And I was singing, and I heard him from his room ask Jagadish, "Is that Mahavir?" and he said, "Tell him to come in." So I kind of quickly, you know, went into Srila Prabhupada's room. And he started talking to me. He goes, "You know," he said, "where in the world are there rivers like the Ganges, the Krishna, the Jamuna?" He says, "India has the most beautiful rivers." He says, "There's only one other place in the world that has a beautiful river." And he said, "The St. Lawrence." And it stunned me. I'm from Canada. And I said, I don't know if he's just saying that to make me feel good. I don't even know if he knows I'm from Canada. But he said that he mentioned the St. Lawrence, you know, that he thought that was a, you know, of all the he named all the rivers in India, and they said one other place, the St. Lawrence. So, and then we talked about water, and he was talking about how all of, and I think he did a lot of this for my benefit, so that I would get the real picture of India, not get fried and burnt with the way India is, like the culture shock. He was talking about cleanliness. And he was talking about how all the local people, their dhotis look dirty. He said, but actually none of those dhotis go 12 hours without being at least washed with water. He said, but because there's so much soil in the water that, you know, they don't use Tide, you know, or bleach, that the dhotis would stay with that kind of reddish or whatever color they had them. He said, but they were always clean. So, you know, he used to talk about the water and sometimes those are the rivers.
When we were in Montreal, Srila Prabhupada had asked the London Yatra to go to London and open a temple. That consisted of Malati and her husband Shyam Sundar, and Jamuna and Guru Das, and Mukunda and Janaki. So they flew from San Francisco to Montreal to see Srila Prabhupada before going to London. Malati had just had a baby, Saraswati. And, of course, they came to see Srila Prabhupada, and Malati's baby was on her hip. She was always dancing with the baby. I was always amazed, you know, legs and arms were kind of flopping. The baby was on her hip when she would be dancing in kirtan. And when they came to see Srila Prabhupada took the baby, little baby Saraswati, held her up over his head and said, "So, do you remember me? I'm your old friend." And, of course, Srila Prabhupada indicated on many occasions that these children are so special. These children are children that have been brought in to spread Lord Chaitanya's movement, that have come from higher places, demigod lokas or higher dimensions, or who knows where they came from, but they've been brought in by Srila Prabhupada's request to spread Lord Chaitanya's mission. And I think one of the most important things that we can do in our lives is to let the children know this, how much Srila Prabhupada counted on them, how much he cared about them, and how important they are to him. Whatever has happened is unfortunate, but this is a very important part. He loved the children very, very much. He taught them, he wanted to teach them everything. When I was in Dallas many years later, he was there for several days in Dallas. He gave lectures. Dayananda was the headmaster at the time. He gave lectures. Every lecture was about teaching them with love, disciplining them only with love. If you love them, they will respond. They will want to do things properly. Not with a heavy hand, but with love. Those lectures, I'm sure, we recorded and are available.
Once I was with Prabhupada and we were talking about my family, because he got to know my mother and father, and, you know, they visited him a few times. And Prabhupada said that, he said, because you are a devotee, he said, 28 generations of your family will be liberated. And I said, well, what do you mean by liberated, Prabhupada? And he said, that means they will become devotees in their next life. I said, wow. I said, does that mean just my immediate family, like my mother and father and brothers and sisters, or does it mean my extended family, aunts and uncles? And he said, no, extended family. He said, everybody, aunts, uncles, everybody, 28 generations of your whole family become devotees.